Good morning, good morning, good morning, classmates. Good morning, Professor Ramirez. I greet you this morning in the name of the Lord. I come before you this morning. I want to deliver the word of God to you. I want to minister to you. Amen. So let's go directly into the word of God. Let's go directly into the word of God. Amen. And the title of my message, is Without Spot or Blemish. Without spot or blemish. The subject is holiness. Our subject is holiness. Amen. The Bible says in Hebrew chapter 12, verse 14, make every effort to live in peace. Make every effort to live in peace with everyone and to be holy. Without holiness, no man shall see the Lord. Without holiness, no man shall see the Lord. Child of God, I want to declare to you that without you living a life for God, without you living a life that is totally and radically changed and transformed, totally living for Christ, you cannot see the kingdom of God. The Bible says that many will come in the last days that they will say, did I prophesy in your name? Did I lay hands and cast out demons in your name? Did I not heal the sick in your name? And the Bible says that Jesus in the last day, that God himself would say, depart from me, you workers of iniquity. I never knew you. I never knew you. Holiness is about a relationship. Holiness is about relationship. It's about being in right standing with God. It's about being in right standing with God. Amen. Let's go somewhere. We're going somewhere. The Bible says in Romans chapter 4, verse 3, and Abraham believed God, and it was accounted to him as righteousness. And Abraham believed God, and it was counted to him as righteousness. Amen. Abraham was not a perfect man. Abraham was a man who came from a background where his father worshiped different idols. His worship was an idol worshiper. He worshiped different gods. Amen. So this is why when God called Abraham, he had to separate him from his father's house. He had to totally remove him from his environment. He had to remove him from what he was used to and what he was comfortable under. Amen. And sometimes when the Lord is trying to take us into a place of holiness, he begins to show us things that deal with our foundation, things that we grew up thinking that it was okay, things that we normally have a sin nature. The Bible says that the spirit man wrestles against the spirit man. The carnal man does not understand the spirit man. So there is always a battle between our flesh and between the spirit. Amen. This is Bible. There is always a continuous battle between the flesh and the spirit. Between the flesh and the spirit. Let's go somewhere. The Bible says in Psalms 91, that those who dwell in the secret place, of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Those who dwell in the secret place, meaning you have to live in the secret place. You have to guard your heart from wickedness. You have to guard your heart from being bitter. You have to guard your heart from being angry. You have to make up your mind that I refuse to be angry. I refuse to be bitter because I want to walk in holiness. I want to walk in right standings with God. Amen. I want to walk in right standings with God. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 5, those who hunger and thirst after righteousness, they shall be filled. Those who hunger and thirst after righteousness, they shall be filled. What is righteousness? Righteousness is right standing with God. Righteousness does not mean that you are perfect. Righteousness does not mean that you have a perfect background, but you have a perfect history. But righteousness means that you understand your rights, that your position in the kingdom of God. Righteousness means that you understand the finished work on the cross. Everything that Jesus did for you on the cross, that it is finished. It is set. Amen.